Hi, this is Pat Johnson, your sociology instructor. In this mini lecture, we're going to talk about the DavisMoore thesis. The DavisMoore thesis says social stratification has beneficial consequences for the operation of a society. What does that mean? What Davis and Moore were saying was that Marx is wrong. Davis and Moore were saying that it's good that there's social stratification in a society and that some jobs get paid way more than others. Let's take a look. My first paycheck job was as a fry cook at a fast food restaurant in Chicago called Jack in the Box. Now, maybe some of you have eaten at a Jack in the Box. It was my first job, and it was in the late 1970s when I was in high school, 16 years old. I got paid $2.30 an hour, if I remember correctly, and that certainly wasn't enough to live on. Karl Marx would have said that I was hardworking, and I was, and that I should get paid much more, a living wage. I should get paid as much as another contributing member of society. Let's say, like a surgeon. Davis and Moore would say, no, somebody who works at a fast food restaurant shouldn't get paid as much as somebody who is a surgeon, or an actor, or a professional athlete. Davis and Moore are saying that the positions in society that get paid a whole lot are desired by the members of that society, and therefore people vote with their dollars. In other words, they're willing to pay for a surgeon or pay for medical insurance to pay for the surgeon. They're willing to pay for cable or a movie ticket. They're willing to pay for a ticket to a professional ball game. And they are worth a whole lot more in our society than your run-of-the-mill fast food employee. I happen to agree with Davis and Moore. I think it's good that some jobs are paid way more than others. But I often find that students say, but you're a teacher. That's really important. You do an important job in our society. Well, I would agree that, yes, my job is important, but there is an ability for many people to be able to do what I do, whereas it takes more education, more time, more training, more skill to be a surgeon. Only a few people can be the A-list actors in Hollywood. Only a few people make it to the major leagues, to the NBA, to the NFL, to play professional sports. So Davis and Moore, again, are saying that social stratification has beneficial consequences for the operation of a society. The greater importance of a position, the more rewards a society attaches to it. Egalitarian societies, in other words, societies where everybody gets paid about the same, offer little incentive for people to try to do their best. If you wanted to be an engineer and you knew how hard the classes were in engineering and the intensity of the schooling, why become an engineer if engineering only paid the same as much as working at Walmart? Not to knock Walmart or McDonald's or any other entry-level position or low-paying position. I've done many of them. But if it's going to take a lot of hard work, a lot of hours, many years, I want that job to be worth a lot more to society. And finally, positions a society considers more important must reward enough to draw talented people. Don't get me wrong, I love being a teacher, and actually, because I have no debt, I think I make plenty of money to live on comfortably. but I don't make millions. I certainly don't make even what would be considered upper middle class in our society. We'll take a look at that in the next lecture. But I make enough, and I think it's adequate reward for the training that I've put into my education and my job. So the DavisMoore thesis, social stratification has beneficial consequences for the operation of a society.